Fire is quite an impressive spectacle, especially when implemented in the form of fireworks. But fireworks wouldn't be nearly as impressive without the wide range of colors they come in. We create these colors by burning different materials. Copper for blue, strontium for red, sodium for yellow, and so on. The wide range of colors we can produce by burning different materials is impressive, but why do they burn different colors in the first place? The answer to this question is more complicated than you might think, going all the way down to the atomic scale. An atom has different allowed energy levels, or shells, for its electrons. When an atom is heated, some of its electrons can move to higher shells very briefly. When they move back to their original shell, they release energy in the form of light. The difference in energy between the two shells corresponds to the wavelength of the light emitted. Of course, the wavelength of light we see isn't the wavelength being created by the electrons, but rather the color that results from the mixing of the wavelengths created by an atom's different shells. So even if a single electron emits a higher frequency packet of light, such as red, the color we see when the element burns can still be lower frequency, such as blue, due to the spacing of other shells. Because every element has different electron shells, different colors result when the atoms are burned. If you haven't seen it already, feel free to check out our last video on why lightning zigzags. For more videos like this, subscribe, and if you have a science question or concept you would like us to cover, please feel free to leave it in the comments. Thanks for watching.